ever wonder how a street in Hawaii got its name? I know I do all the time. That's why we have Aloha Authentic every Thursday, delving into parts of Hawaii's culture. This week, Kamaka Pili takes us to a street on Hawaii Island named after one of the five volcanoes there. Here he is now.
Aloha mai, it's Kamaka Pili. We're here on the island of Hawaii in the moku of Hilo and in the ahupua'a of Waiakea to share with you this street known as Hualalai Street. And it gets its name from one of the five volcanoes that make up this island. Hualalai is known to be the third most active following Mauna Loa and Kilauea. Now the last eruption dated for this volcano was back in 1801, and looking at some stories, it's believed, or it's shared at least, that King Kamehameha was able to stop one of the flows of Hualalai by offering a lock of his hair to Tutupele and the lava. Now a majority of the west side of our island is created by old flows from this volcano, and that includes big portions where hotels and resorts are operated today. Now, speaking with some scientists, they say that it's not if, but when this volcano will next erupt. And according to them, they expect it to erupt within the next 100 years or so. So keep that in mind. Did you know? Now you do.
Awesome. And Kamaka Pili joins us now. Good morning.
Good morning, Kathy.
We're usually together on the weekend.
Yes, it's good to see you outside of the weekend.
Same here. Okay, so Hualalai. And you mentioned also Mauna Loa,
yes.
Kilauea,
Mauna Kea, as well as Kohala, which is the oldest volcano on Hawaii Island.
Okay, and then there's also Lo'ihi right now,
yes.
Right?
So Lo'ihi is considered a submarine volcano to the southeast of Hawaii Island. And submarine volcano meaning that it hasn't emerged through the ocean yet. And that has been active for about 400,000 years or so, and they expect it to emerge through the ocean within the next 10 to 100,000 years.
Wow. Isn't
becoming
it amazing?
The ninth Hawaiian island.
Wow. And then you mentioned Kamehameha giving an offering.
Yes.
And it stopped the flow. Are
yes.
there other stories like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, there's one in more recent times according to that one. But in 1880, there is a princess by the name of Ruth Ke'elikolani who was called from Oahu to go to Hawaii Island as Mauna Loa was erupting, and the flow from that was threatening Hilo Town. So they called her to, knowing that she was still very rich in the old traditional ways and believed in the old gods. So she came in and she did her ho'okupu, or offering. I believe she offered brandy, alcohol, that alcoholic beverage, also red handkerchiefs and other things as well. But doing so, then story shares that she slept alongside the flow that night, woke up the next morning, and the lava had stopped in its tracks where it was.
Wow, beautiful story.
Yeah.
Speaking of Hualalai, can you say the word again? Because there's that kahako
yes.
over the second A, right?
So it's Hualalai compared to Hualalai. The kahako, which is the line over the vowel letters, create a prolonged sound to the vowel. So a better example is the word eha versus eha. So eha with the line over the A means the number four. Eha with no lines over the A, no kahakos, refers to pain or being hurt. So the kahako changes the sound of the word dramatically, but also could dramatically change the meaning of the word.
Wow, dramatically
yeah.
change. So Hualalai.
Hualalai versus Hualalai.
Hualalai. Okay. And then, of course, Hawaii Island, everybody also knows it has the nickname of the Big Island.
Yes.
Are there other nicknames?
Yeah, the nickname prior to that is known as the Orchid Isle, which you don't need to hear that as often now, but that's the island that was and continues to have a lot of orchid farms.
Yeah.
So it was Orchid Isle and then Big Island, which I know Christine asked last week if that was okay to use nicknames, which definitely is. You know, it's just nowadays with a big push for Olelo Hawaii and speaking Hawaiian language and properly, we try to urge to use Hawaii Island instead.
All right. Thank you so much, Kamaka.
Mahalo,
it's great to talk story
yes.
with you.